Hi everyone, this is Martin for Codecademy, and today we'll be going over how to set up SQLite locally on your Windows machine. Now, this video is aimed for those of you that have taken the Learn SQL course, or you're looking to set up SQLite locally on your machine. If those concepts are not familiar to you, make sure to go to the Learn SQL course on Codecademy to catch up. Now, let's get started. Here's the lesson plan for today. We'll download SQLite for our Windows machine and run it, and then we'll download some sample data so we have something to play around with. And last, we're going to run some demo queries to show you that we do indeed have a working SQLite installation. What things do we need to know before going into this video? Well, as mentioned, this video is aimed at those that have just finished up the Codecademy SQL course, or those looking to get started with SQL on their own. All of this means that you should have some exposure to SQL. If you don't, fear not. We have three separate courses on SQL, as well as the Analyze Data with SQL skill path, all of which will help you cover this prerequisite. For the purposes of this video, we're going to be using the terminal, so you should be familiar with basic navigation and command line tools. Nothing magical is going to be happening, but if you want to brush up on your skills, go check out the command line courses on Codecademy. All right, let's get our hands dirty. First thing we need to do is actually download SQLite. Navigate to the SQLite downloads URL, which you can see here, or find it through searching for SQLite download in Google. Once on this page, scroll down until you see the downloads for Windows. We want to download the bundle, which has all of the tools that we're going to use. Once it's finished downloading, copy your download to a folder of your choosing, and I'm just going to drop it in my learning folder. Right click on it, go extract here, and now you have your three files which comprise our SQLite installation. From here, we could just click on the SQLite.exe file, and you should get this terminal pop up. Now, this isn't going to be super interesting. You see we have no databases inside, so let's actually download some datasets that we can play around with. To get started with some datasets, we're going to use the SQLite data starter packs, which you can find by just typing into Google SQLite data starter packs. You should navigate to this page, and then from here, let's download this dataset. We're going to do the same thing. Once it downloads, copy it over to this folder. We're going to just copy it here for simplicity. Okay, so we have our SQLite files and our dataset. Let's actually run it and see something interesting. We are going to hide the browser for now because we don't need it anymore. And we're going to open up a terminal. Now that we have our terminal, we can navigate to our folder. My folder is on D drive, learning, and then this is just the folder that we extracted from our bundle. If you do an ls, we can see we have the same thing as this folder. So now to run SQLite, all we need to do is just run this file with this parameter, and we see we are now inside the SQLite command prompt, and we can do our normal select all from states command, and this would output the data in the states table. Let's clear the screen and just enter back into our command prompt again. To look at the actual table definitions for the tables that we have, we can just type dot schema, and this is going to output the create table commands that were used to create the tables for this particular data set. And if we want to run a more interesting query to, let's say, sort all the states by their per capita income, we could run this command. We could do a select. We select the name and the per capita income of each state, hit return, continue typing our command from the states table, and we want to order our results by the per capita income in ascending order. And you can see this outputs the results from our query. Let's run another one just for the sake of showing. And let's run a query to sort all the states by their median age. To do that, we can just do a select, and then we want to select the names and the median age of the states from the states table. And we want to, again, order by the median age, and we want to do it in ascending fashion. And you can see these are all of our states ordered by their median age. So there we have it. That is a full installation of SQLite on Windows. However, we have a small problem. If we are in any other folder on our file system and we try to run the SQLite command, we're going to end up with a command not found. The reason for that is because we haven't actually added the execution file to our path. To add SQLite to our path, open up the control panel, and in the little search box, type env, short for environment, and we can click edit environment variables for your account. If you go down to path, you can click edit, and here you can copy, create a new entry, paste this file path. Now this is gonna be different for your account. This is just gonna be wherever you have extracted the SQLite bundle. Hit okay, hit okay, close this. You might need to close your terminal and reopen it again. Okay, we closed and refreshed our terminal, and now we can type SQLite 3, and you can see we're now into the SQLite command prompt from just any folder.